Hi, welcome to CalAm Lifestyle University acrylic painting class. I'm Deb Kannenberg, and today we're going to be working on this adorable little fence with a wagon wheel and some daisies in front of it. So I hope that you enjoy this painting and will join us again next month. Hi. To get started, I'm going to put some paints on my palette. I am going to start with Cellulane Blue, Phthalo Blue, Cobalt Blue, Viridian Green, Emerald Green, Raw Umber, and of course White. So once I have that all on my palette, I'm going to dip my brush in some water and then wipe it off. And I'm going to mix a nice blue for the sky using all my blues, and I want it to be varied and shaded. So I'm just going to start painting in that sky with my blues and my whites till I get the color that I want in my sky. If my brush gets a little dry, I'm just going to add some water. And I'm going to go about two-thirds of the way down, so right to about there. And I'm going to let it be a little shaded because it is sky. It does have some clouds in it. Of course, it does have some clouds in the sky. You can make your sky however you want it. If you want it to be pure blue, like the Arizona skies are a lot of times, you can do that. But if you want it to look like it has a little clouds, you can feather them in a little bit. How clouds would look. A little sky. I'm going to make it a little darker towards the horizon. And I'm pretty good with that. So I'm going to leave that, and I'm going to work on to the bottom half of my painting. On the bottom, I'm going to rinse out my brush, wipe it off. I'm going to start with some raw umber, a little bit, and some white, mostly white. And I'm going to give my bottom just a little sandy coat, just like dirt. Just to give it that appearance of dirt. I had a little bit of blue in my brush. I'm not going to worry about that because we're going to be going over this with green because it's going to become grasses. So I'm going to go, I'm pretty happy with that, and I'm going to leave it dry so I can start on my grasses. Okay, I'm ready to start my grasses, which will be behind and in front of the fence. We'll paint the fence, and then we'll probably have to add some more grasses. So I'm going to take some of my Viridian Green, a little bit of my Emerald Green, pull in a little white. I want this to be a little darker, so I'm going to use mostly the Viridian Green. And I'm going to start putting in some grasses. Again, I'm using the same brush. I'm going to use side strokes on it, so I don't want too much paint on my brush. And I'm just going to start by coming up with some grasses. Just flicking them up into the sky. Not covering the whole surface because we're going to come around with some more. Grass kind of grows in little clumps. This will be the darkest layer. Just gonna keep going. I'm gonna add a little bit lighter green and come in there. This would be the emerald green. Don't overthink this because we're going to be painting some things in front of it. Mix your colors because we have all different kinds of colors here. Just going to give my front here a little bit of fullness. Try and get as close to some coverage as I can get. Mixing my greens up a little bit, trying to get some nice coverage. And I'm going to leave it sit at that for a minute, and I need to let that dry. Now with chalk or whatever you're drawing with, we're going to start by drawing in the fence. And I think my fence is about my hand's width, half of my hand here on the grass and half on the sky. So I want my fence to come right along here, my top rail of the fence. And it's a double fence, so I'm gonna put in the bottom line. And then my bottom line of the fence is gonna come right here, and it's mostly gonna get covered up by grass, but we're gonna put it there. So I hope you can see my fence pretty good. And now I'm gonna start putting in the pickets to my fence. So I'm just gonna come up, get kind of a rounded top, bring it back down, up, kind of a rounded or pointed top. Yeah, I got maybe a half of one there. Don't have to put that one in. We'll see how it comes along. So now I've got my fence drawn in. So next thing we're going to paint is the fence. So if your brush is rinsed out or soaking in the water, wipe most of the green paint off. So our paper towel comes in handy to wipe that brush off a little bit. And now we're going to start using the burnt umber that we put on our plate. We're going to be mixing that with some white. So pull it out until you have a color about this consistency or this color. Just pull it out and we're going to start painting the fence. The first thing we're going to paint is the long rail because that goes behind the pickets. So it's about the width of your brush, so just take it down. And a split rail is kind of an old fence, so you don't have to be real cautious about going real straight because it is an old fence. And you're gonna do that the same on the bottom. Don't need to be quite as fussy on the bottom because we're gonna be covering that with a lot of the grasses. We're going to be adding some highlights to this fence as we go along. Once I have my bottom boards done, I'm going to start on my pickets. And again, it's the raw umber. This is just the base coat. It's going to be having a lot more highlights. So, and of course this one's going to be kind of behind the wagon wheel, so, but this is definitely in front of the bottom board. And if you streak in a little bit of dark paint, that's okay. I'm going to add a lot to these yet. It's an old fence, so it's kind of rough. If you put your pickets farther apart and you don't have that half one in the corner, that's okay. You don't have to do it exactly like mine. I'm just going to put that half picket right there. It goes right off the page. And I'm going to start working on highlighting my fence because it does have some dark spots to it. So I'm going to take some of my dark umber and I'm going to start putting some streaks or cracks in this wood. Again, I'm using the side of my brush. Just coming along and adding some creeks or cracks. Shades of the wood. It's like an old picket fence. If you think you've got a little too much, that's okay too. We can come across and then do the same on your picket, on your rail, excuse me. And I'm going to make my lines closer to the bottom on the rail. And again, a lot of that's going to get covered up. Okay, now I'm going to put a little black on my palette. So I'm going to come around and make the sideboard of that fence. So again, I'm going to take a little smaller brush, the next size down of my flat brush. I've had mine soaking in the water. And I'm going to wipe the water off. And I'm going to mix a little bit of brown with the black. I don't want it to be a real pure black, but I want it to be kind of quite dark. So I'm gonna mix that nice color. And I'm gonna come around the fence here and I'm gonna put that side on the fence, on the pickets. I'm going to do that on all of them, all the way down the line. Coming from the top, it's kind of like the side of the picket because it's in the shadow. And of course, this one is off the thing, so it's not good. Off the page, so it's going to have, and you know, sometimes that gives your painting a little dimension to take something right off the page. So then I'm just going to pull a little bit of dark in the rest of the wood, just with what I have, a little bit of dry that I have on my brush. And I'm going to give that bottom rail that same shadow. Very lightly and just between them. Just to start to give it a little bit of dimension. I'm thinking I'm a little light up here. I want to be a little darker, so I'm just going to add I mixed a little bit of white and black and with the very dry, just to give the wood some grain. I guess grain is a good word. Give it some shadows on the bottom. I want it to be a little darker on the bottom to appear like a shadow. The darker side of the wood. Added a little bit of white to my brush, and I want to make sure that I don't make all the wood dark. And if you do that, like I just did, and you think you got a little too much on, just spread it out a little bit and give your board some line and some character. Add some dark towards the bottom. Give it a little bit of a shadow on this side of the, this one can be a little darker in the cracks. And if I think I've got it too dark, I can always come back and just add a little bit of light mixed with the brown. And just kind of play with it, mix it, but don't overthink it. And I'm thinking I have a little bit too much. And you can do this with your painting. If you're unhappy here, I think I went into the blue a little bit with my black. I can always come along and add a little blue. Got to be sure it's really dry. Sometimes, like me, you're making it worse. Okay, so I'm pretty good with that. And I'm gonna let that dry, and then we're gonna start working on the wagon wheel. Okay, as we start to talk about putting the wagon wheel on the fence, and we're going to do that with our chalk, first you need to understand kind of the parts of the wagon wheel. And if you look at the first painting that I did of this, the wagon wheel has a definite rim around it, and then it has an inside rim. But because of the way we're looking at it, you only see part of it. And then, of course, it has the spokes. So I want my wagon wheel to appear as though it's leaning on the fence. So depending on if your fence is going up this way or straight across, that will decide how round you want to make your wheel. So if I make my wheel on an angle a little bit, it's going to look more like it's leaning than if it were straight on round. So I'm going to make my wheel a little bit on an oval, and I want my wheel to kind of go off the page. So I'm going to draw it so it comes up almost to the top and around and to the bottom, because I want it to appear that it's resting, and I'm going to let it run off the page. Now remember, I said it has two parts. It has the outer rim, and then it has that inner rim where the spokes go. So because of the way I'm looking at my rim, that outer rim isn't going to be seen, that inner rim, the whole way around. It's going to end about there and come around. And then of course I've got a hub. So my hub, and I actually think I might want mine a little rounder. And that's the beauty of chalk, you can change it. So I'm going to put my hub not quite in the center, just a little bit off towards the bottom and to the right. And I'm going to draw a good enough circle there, because the hub also has that part that you only see from one side. So it's going to have like a little half moon on the left side. And then of course it's going to have the center home. So now my eight spokes are going to come out of that wheel. And they are narrower at the wheel, or they're wider at the wheel, excuse me, and narrower at the hub. So I don't want it to interfere too much with my post. So I'm going to put it over here, and it's going to go to the center of that rim. So I've got two. I'm going to put it opposite each other, so I'm going to come down here and it's going to get wider, and then I'm going to put one here and it goes to the center of that rim, and here, and then I can just go and put my other ones in. Now remember that these on this side will go to the center of that dark part we're going to put on the bottom. So we'll work on that last, and I'll explain it more as we go along. So my wheel seems awfully close to me to the bottom of the fence, which makes it look like it's falling forward, and I'm not liking that. So I'm going to correct that right now. And anytime, remember I said you want to take chalk off your page, you just gotta take a little wet brush. So I want my wheel to come down a little further. So it appears more that it's sitting. So when that dries, I might want to make it a little rounder. And that's the beauty of this, you can make all those adjustments. So now that I've done that, I want to bring my wheel a little rounder, and I want to bring it down further so that it doesn't appear. So my spokes can come in the same spot, they just have to be a little longer. And I think I'm more happy with that. It looks more like it's leaning on the fence. So now that I've got that far, I'm going to give it all that first basic lighter coat, just like we did the fence. So I'm going to use my medium-sized brush, medium-sized flat brush, and I'm going to take some burnt umber. And if your paint's dried up a little bit on your plate, and mine does because I've waited for it to dry, you can add some more paint to your palette. So you need burnt umber, some black eventually, a little bit of white, and you might want to add a little bit of yellow or orange in there. Okay, so again, mix some burnt umber with some white to get that kind of brownish tan color. And we're going to start painting that wagon wheel. Now, remember again that the wheel has those two parts to it. So there's going to be, your wheel's going to come around. This is going to be the rim of your wheel. Painted my wheel round. Now on this side, it's going to have that inner, that very inner wheel, and that's going to be pretty dark. So you want to add some black into your romber, and you're going to paint that part in. And that's right below your rim. It gets wider. And it'll get narrower towards the bottom. And that's that inner rim. And I use the side of my brush quite a bit to make it thinner. Okay, and now I can start to paint my spokes, and they're going to be that lighter beigey color again. And we're going to be adding all kinds of highlights to them, so like we did to the fence, so don't worry about it too much. So like when it comes right down to the hub, right next to the... Now when I come to these that are against the inner spoke, they're going to come halfway into that spoke, into that inner rim. So when I come around, and I know they're not real defined right now, but they will be. I'm going to come around here and I'm going to put this spoke in. It's going to go halfway into that black rim. And then right down to the outer edge of my hub. Same thing over here. It's going to come halfway in. And if you feel you need to use a smaller brush, feel free. And then here they're going to come all the way down to the rim. And I'm going to start highlighting my rims with black. I'm actually going to take the smaller flat brush now because I'm going to be working on those small rims. And black with just a tad of raw umber, so it's not a real starchy black. I'm going to go around these spokes and I'm going to highlight them on the bottom because they're going to be dark on the bottom because the sun is coming from the top. And of course, they're going to be darker towards the hub, too. I'm just going to define them a little bit.
Like a celery sandwich of love, and I'm the baloney.
And here you can see that my spoke is getting a little muddled with the wood on my fence, but that's okay because we're going to be putting some grass in there. So just make sure you go all the way up to your hub there. And then I'm going to paint that hub in, and I'm going to paint the outside of it first. I'm going to mix a little bit of that lighter colored brown again. I'm going to paint this moony thing, and I'm going to follow it around the shape of it with my brush. Then the outside edge, I want to be a little bit darker. So I'm just going to come in with my brush and give that outside edge a little bit of darkness, giving it some definition. That makes it kind of pop out because it is it does stand out from the wheels. And then the center of my hub is again that lighter brown. Mine didn't get very light, very dark light, but it's all right. I can come into it with some white. Let that hub sit for a minute. Play with my spokes a little bit. Just to get them to look like spokes. Don't worry too much because there'll be some grasses there. I'm just making sure that these spokes come all the way to the hub. And they go all the way into the starting to be pretty happy with that. The hub has a little bit of detail on the inside. It has a center darker dot. You might want to wait till you dry a little bit more to put that in. And it has a couple little lines coming out. And that center hub. And we're going to do some more defining too when we get a smaller brush out there. Let's put some texture on the rim of the wheel with some burnt umber and some white, probably a little bit more white, and I keep calling it burnt umber. It's raw umber. I apologize. So I'm just going to come around my wheel and give it some little Then, of course, shadows always kind of lurk in the dark spots. So there's obviously going to be some shadows on under the hull here. So I'm going to pull in some darker colors there. And I need to add a little bit of black because I'm almost out. And again, you don't want to make it stark black because it's a shadow. It's not. So you might want to add just the tip of your brush and some white, and then just pull some little shadows in there. It's always going to be darker where it attaches. And start to see it taking some shape. I'm going to put a little bit of whiter highlights, lighter gray, white on the center of my hub in between those little lines. Just giving my hub some definition. Little black shadows underneath my spokes here. I'm starting to be pretty happy with the way my wagon wheel looks. I may come and touch it up a little bit more later. But now, around the outside of a wagon wheel, there's always a black rim. So I'm going to get my smallest brush, my finest brush, and some black paint. And using the finest stroke that I can, I'm going to come around this whole rim. Very lightly. there where I got a little dark, I'll just come in and pull in some browns. It's hard to have a pretty steady hand there. Browns and some whites. Kind of pull it in. Make it look halfway round anyway. Now I'm going to let that completely dry. Play with my wheel a little. I'm not quite as happy. As I could be with that. There, I'm liking that a little better. I'm pretty happy with that. So I'm going to soak my brush in. I'm going to let that dry, and the next thing I'm going to work on is the rest of the grass and maybe putting some daisies in or some flowers of some kind and see where we come from there. Okay, let's start working on putting in some additional grasses. So make sure you still have some greens on your plate. And you might want to add a little yellow and orange. And this time we're going to pull some greens over the top of the wheel. So you want the grass to be in front of the wheel. Grass grows all different directions and all different colors. Green. I'm going to even bring some way up. And I want some to be also in front of my fence a little bit. And again, they're darker and they're lighter and they're mixed. And I haven't used any yellow yet, so I'm saving that for some highlights. And I want some to even go over the fence just a little bit. I want it to look like it's a little deeper grass. Now I'm going to pull in a little yellow into my greens, maybe a little white. Put some brighter highlights in there. My paints are getting a little dry. Some yellows. Don't worry if you think they're a little too yellow. You can always come over them again with some green. Blend them in a little bit. Add a little white. some of that bright green. I've mixed some of the Viridian green with some yellow. Give me some brighter colors, a brighter green. I'm probably going to be pretty happy with that. A little white showing through there that I don't like. I'm just going to touch it up with some green. And I think that looks pretty good. Liking that, so now I'm going to let it dry and then we'll decide to put some flowers on it. And you can put several different kinds of flowers on this if you want. I put some daisies on this one, flat brush medium, and I'm going to use some white. Do that as I pull the white out onto my brush. So if you don't want to do those kind of flowers, you can do any really kind of flower that you want. I'm going to show you how I'm going to do those. And I'm going to mix a little yellow with a little orange, a little white for my cap. That's not quite yellow enough. So I'm just going to make that cap like we talked about, and I'm going to make it quite small. I'm going to make it flat on the top and then round it down just a little. I'm gonna make those anywhere I want a flower. Whoops. I have that taped up so you could see. So I'm gonna put that anywhere I want a flower and just flat across the top and round it down a little bit. It's mostly yellow that I'm using. Flat on the top, round it down. Flat on the top, round it down. I'm going to put one right here in front of the fence, and I might put a little one right over here, and then maybe one right here in the corner going off the page. Again, flat on the top, round it on the bottom. I'm going to rinse out my brush. I'm going to use a round brush to do my daisy petals, and I'm just going to start at the far edge. I'm going to put my brush down and I'm going to just going to stroke it down, flatten it down, bring it out, flatten it down, bring it out, flatten down, bring it out, flatten it down, bring it out. I'm going to do the same thing. Flatten it down, bring it out. I'm not going to make these too big. Flatten it down, bring it out. I'm using my white already. And if I have some that overlap, that's okay. That's actually good. They should. Flatten down, bring it out. I'm losing it again. Flat it down, bring it out. Flat it down, bring it out. I have my daisies in there. Hopefully that'll stay up there. Then I think I'm gonna peek a little daisy out behind, from behind. So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna peek it out from behind one of the wheels here. I'm just gonna press it down and pull it out. Put it down there, and maybe a little bit it's gonna show here. And I could do some little tiny ones behind the fence, just so it looks like little tiny flowers back there. And I see some of these that are in front of the wood, you might have to go over another time, so because they get a little transparent. My daisies are kind of yellowy. I'm gonna put this down here. Can you still see it? Yeah. So I'm gonna add a little white. I'll just kind of go over them a little bit. Kind of like that. I'm going to take the thinnest brush that I have again, one of my thinnest brushes, and I'm just going to give them a couple stems with a raw umber, very lightly. I don't want much paint on my brush at all. It's hard to paint when it's on the bottom. I'm just going to come down very lightly with a little stem. Don't even have to be on all of them. If you think that got a little dark, just add a little green. Pull it up. Really wish that would stay. Put a couple stems in front of those. Leaves. Here we go. If I think that some of my flowers are a little dull, just come across them with a little bit of yellow. But I kind of like them with that little bit of orange in them. She's not cooperating. And you know, I might decide that I want a daisy over here going off my page. So I'm just gonna make a cap, like before, and I'm going to get some white, and I'm going to make the stems. This is not doing well for me. So, and again, it's just touch and pull, touch and pull. And I think that adds a little bit. I need to put a little orange in that. Apply a paint. And I think I'm looking pretty good. Don't forget to sign your painting, and I'll see you next month.